This is an introduction to the video program all about epilepsy. It is designed to show you how to recognize and manage seizures. It describes the different types of epilepsy and offers advice on how to help someone who is having a seizure. And we also hear from a few people who live with epilepsy.
I think when you get a new diagnosis of epilepsy, it can be a big shock and you can be very upset. It's a very emotional time. But for me, the moment I embraced it and started living life with it and didn't fight it, things just calmed down.
This program is all about epilepsy. And
how to. The program is presented by epilepsy consultant Dr. Arjun Sen.
Someone who has repeated seizures has epilepsy, and it's common. Around 1 in every 100 people in the UK has epilepsy. That's over 500,000 people. Anyone can develop epilepsy. It happens in all races and social classes, and it can start at any age. All epileptic seizures start in the brain. Our brains work by sending and receiving electrical messages between nerve cells and our body.
Sorry, can you repeat that?
Well, what I was about to say was...
With the help of actors, the programme demonstrates different types of seizure, from a simple focal seizure through to tonic-clonic seizures. People with epilepsy have the same experiences and expectations as everyone, but they know it can be a difficult subject to talk about.
I've had seizures in front of people I work with, I've had seizures at trade shows, I've had seizures with colleagues in the street, which is partly why I tell everyone I have it, because then they can deal with me when I've had a seizure.
There is a misunderstanding of the word. It's called sara' in Arabic, and it means epilepsy. But this word at the same time means like the someone if he's possessed with demons and all this. So whenever the word sara' is mentioned, people will just have this idea that someone is possessed with demon and all this.
Encouraging people to talk about it, I think, is really important because it helps to dispel those myths and talk to other people about it. And the best people to explain it are people who've had experience of living with epilepsy.
I've been very lucky in that I've been in a hospital which have epilepsy nurses, and it means that whenever I've had a problem, say for example if I needed to take a drug that's not related to epilepsy, I've always got in touch with them, and I found them to be a huge help.
The way I have coped with my epilepsy has been to look at what I can do rather than focus my attention on what I can't do. If I look at what I can do, the epilepsy becomes irrelevant.
People have other diseases that are even more far dangerous than epilepsy. So don't let it, whatever you got, control you. You should get control of your life.
Make sure it doesn't define you as a person. Otherwise it becomes all about your health and less about you as a person.